All right, so we're gonna head in a little bit of a different direction. We've talked a little bit about why watersheds are important. We know that we need to do education on watersheds. So a little bit about me. My name is Lynn Pileski. I am the Education Program Coordinator at the Greenville County Soil and Water Conservation District in South Carolina, which is a lot to say. I'm also with my compatriot, Shelby Cohen, who is not here. She's down at the Sheriff Fair right now. We are state coordinators for Project WET in South Carolina. So, you need a watershed curriculum, and NACD has been great and has provided all of these materials, but let's say you want to go a little bit more in depth, or you want to cover topics that are water related, but that are other than watershed specifically. What do? You are a district person. You don't have time to be doing curricula or making sure that it's all correlated with your state standards and everything. We have the answer for you. Project WET. How many of you are familiar with Project WET? Okay, I'm done. Everybody knows about it. So it's water education for teachers. For those who don't know, it is standards-based, award-winning curricula to educate on all topics water. So the mission of Project WET, as you can see, is to reach children, parents, educators, and communities of the world with water education. Project WET works on these core beliefs, and the beliefs are that water connects us all, we want to manage water sustainably, water for all water users, and we each should take personal responsibility for the quality of our water and the quantity of our water. So WET works on a tiered level. So first is the Project WET Foundation, and they are located in Bozeman, Montana. Project WET has been around since 2005. So they kind of develop all the curriculum, they work on the activity guides, all the different books that we have up here. And this whole table up in the front has samples of the activity guide, all of the different books and publications that Project WET has, and the two other projects that I'll talk about a little bit. From there are the coordinators, and they are state coordinators. There is at least one coordinator in every state. Some of the larger states, like Texas, they may have more than one coordinator, just for purposes of, they break it up regionally. Then you have your facilitators. The coordinators train the facilitators, and the facilitators actually lead the workshop for educators. And it's not just for teachers. These are the people who can take these workshops are informal educators, like your district staff, your district education people, and your coordinators. Also, any sort of conservation-related groups, pretty much anyone who has an interest in teaching kids or their community about water is eligible to attend a Project WET workshop. And what do you get? You get the Project WET activity guide. It contains 64 activities that cover every aspect of water, from what is the chemical composition of water to what are watersheds, how does pollution flow through your waterway, what can you do to conserve water. And the workshops are for these educators. It is the only way that you can get one of these Project WET activity guides. And just a side note, if you go and you attend a workshop and you get an activity guide, that activity guide is yours. It belongs to you, and when you leave your place of employment, that guide goes with you, and the next person who comes in has to take a workshop. So the other thing about Project WET is that it's interdisciplinary. So you may have some folks who say, well, I'm not really a science teacher, so this doesn't relate to me. This is not something that is for me. But these different activities, they cover everything from art, math, graphing, charts, English. Some of them are writing activities. So that they cover all these different things, even physical education. So, great, how much is it gonna cost you? I'm sure that this wonderful curriculum is gonna cost you a pile of dollars. Not so much. The WET workshops, it varies state to state, but generally speaking, a WET workshop is around $40 for you to attend. It's a 6-hour workshop, and you get the activity guide. you'll actually physically go through some of the activities, so you will leave the workshop with a good sense of how these activities run and how to do some. And I'm rushing through this because we have activities for you to do this afternoon.
Did you say 6 hours?
6 hours, mm-hmm. And again, $25 to $40 per person. In some states, depending on what the state governing authority is for Project Well, like we're a conservation district, so we don't have the cash to put out to pay for all of our educators' activity guides. We did write a grant, and Duke Energy was able to, they funded a grant for us so that we can give scholarships to educators who are within the Duke Energy service area. So thus far in the past year in that grant period, we had 201 educators go through this at no cost, well, tiny cost to them. We discovered that it was better to charge the educators $5 for lunch so that they would actually show up, because if you didn't charge them, they didn't show up and they reserved, and that was trouble. So now we have other, WED has other projects and topics. In addition to this activity guide, the Project WET Foundation has also done all these different series. So we've got Discover a Watershed, Floods, Healthy Water, Healthy People, WOW, which is Wonders of Wetlands. And then there are local and regional ones as well. Like this one happens to be Conserve Water and Arizona Conserve Water. So really, if there's a topic that you want to teach about, WET's got you covered. We have also the children's activity books, and there are samples of all of these up front. So we have something like 80 topics that are covered with these children's activity books. Some are topical, some are local, like Lake Tahoe has their own activity book because the Lake Tahoe people put that together. And the other two projects, these conservation themes work together. So in addition to Project WET, there's Project Learning Tree. We've all heard of that, yes? Right? Which is everything forestry and trees. And Project WILD, which is animals and wildlife. So Project Learning Tree curriculum, they have all these different things. They have the K-12. Most of these activities all base around a main guide, and then they have the accompanying activities. I did not, in order to conserve paper, I did not print these out for you. So if you're interested in Project Learning Tree and finding a coordinator or a facilitator in your area, go to plt.org and you can find a facilitator in your area. Project WILD, same thing, they're at projectwild.org, but they have all these. Project WILD has Growing Up Wild, which is early childhood, Flying Wild, Wild Aquatic. They have a whole bunch of different ones too. And again, I've got copies of all these books up here. We're in our district, we are facilitators for Project WILD and Learning Tree, so we can do workshops, but we have different, Project Learning Tree is under our forestry division, and then Project WILD has individual coordinators in our state. So, now that we've breezed through all of that, what time is it? Oh, we have tons of time left. Kalina here has one activity from Project WET, which is some of the parts. But let me do, we'll do Blue Planet before that. And this is one of our basic Project WET activities. So y'all can hear me, right? Okay, so we have this Earth globe here. Who has a guess as to how much of the Earth's surface is covered by water?
75%.
75%, does anybody think it's more or less than that? Pretend you're third graders.
70.
Somebody say 20, okay. So what we're going to do is we're gonna play a little game with this. This is the globe, and what we do is we play a little game where we toss the globe, and where your right thumb lands, you're going to say whether it's earth or water. Can I have someone who would volunteer to tally for me?
I am.
She'll do it. Okay. You're videotaping. You don't get it. So when we toss the globe to you, look where your right thumb lands. Tell us whether it's landed on water or whether it's landed on land, and tell us your name and where you're from. Ready?
Land. I'm Melody Newman, and I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio.
What?
I held my thumbs in the Pacific Ocean. I'm Benoit from Kansas.
Reality and what the thing, the correct number should be. But you can do this, you can have someone tally it up on the board and they can figure out percentages. When we do this with little kids, we say to them, okay, here's four people. If you had to figure out how many of these people were represent water and how many represent land, they guess all over the place, and then you get to figure out the percentages. So it's percentages. You can do this with pony beads on chenille straws, what we used to call pipe cleaners, but now we have to call them chenille straws. Because apparently tobacco and stuff, you know. But you can put green ones on for land and blue ones on for water, so that makes bar charts for them. And so, also, if you do this with real little kids, they can sit in a circle and roll it so that it doesn't get violent. Usually what we'll do is we'll make it so that every kid gets a chance to grab the globe, and so they'll toss it when they've gone, they sit down, so that kind of keeps track of it so nobody feels left out. But this is one of our main activities for Project WET. It's an easy one, and we have prizes. You came from farthest away. We should ask questions.
Yes.
What year was Project WET started?
2005.
Who said that? Let's see, what other questions? What other questions should we ask, Meg?
What are the three
big projects?
Project three.
Alright, I'm throwing. I'm catching. Alright, this one. Okay. We're just throwing stuff. And the next activity we're going to do is called Sum of the Parts, and Kalita is gonna lead that one.
Okay.